Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to make some cool HUD elements using shape layers. You can easily create these in After Effects using shape layers, but just a word of caution, you'll be creating a lot of groups inside your shape layers, so labeling is essential. As with all shape layers, these can be saved as presets for future use, so when you have time, you can create a ton of these and then bank them up for future projects. This is going to be a fun episode, and there's a lot to get through. So let's dive right in. Okay, so I'm going to create a new composition. You can create any size you want. I'm going to go with our standard 1920 by 1080. And I'm just going to call this HUD element. And so we're going to create this entire thing using one shape layer and a ton of groups. So right click in this area down here, and let's go new shape layer. And we'll just call this layer HUD element. And let's go ahead and open up our shape layer. So now right off the bat, I'm going to let you know there's going to be a lot of groups in here. So make sure that you label these in a way that's easy for you to navigate through them. Go ahead and add our first group. And I'm going to start from the outermost and go in. And I'll explain why in just 1 second. So we'll say outer ring. And we're just going to add an ellipse. And we're going to add a stroke. And we'll leave this stroke white for now and make it 1.5 width. And I'm going to turn off my guides here. Okay, so let's just increase the size of this ellipse. As you see, these groups duplicate upwards. So now we can just take the second ellipse path and make it a little bit smaller. Let's duplicate that ring, and we'll make this one even smaller. Duplicate that. Now, there are no rules on how these are supposed to look, so you can get creative with these and just kind of add as many of these elements as you want. Okay, so for now, I'm going to add in one more. And then I'm going to go back later and rename these so that way they're easier to kind of keep track of. Here are all of our rings. Let's go down to this last ring. We're going to duplicate that, and let's call this blue. And then we're going to decrease our size where it comes about midways between the last two rings. And we're going to increase our stroke until it fills it up. So you can kind of adjust this until you get it just right. Then we're going to change this to a blue. And let's go ahead and add another group. And we're going to call this group blue segments. I'm going to move this blue segments folder right above the outer ring and put our blue layer in there. Then let's open this up, and with blue segments highlighted, we're going to add a trim paths, and let's set our end percentage to 15. Okay, and then let's move this trim paths inside of our blue layer there, so that way it's nested inside of here. And then we're going to duplicate this blue group and open up our trim paths and set our offset to 180 so they're on opposite sides. So I just duplicated this ring, which is right here. And I'm going to do the same thing I did with our blue rings, make it smaller, and then increase our stroke width, add a trim pass to that, set our end to 40. Let's go to outer ring 5 here. If you come down to outer ring 5 stroke, you see this option for dashes, just hit the plus sign. And I see this looks a little funky there, so you want to kind of adjust how many dashes you have. Rename this dash, and maybe we'll make this color kind of a red. Increase our stroke to say 5, and then let's go to our first ring and let's just increase our stroke width, and maybe we'll make that like a green, and we can add a trim pass to this as well and set our end percentage to 45 and maybe decrease our stroke width a little bit. Let's go to our second ring here and we'll increase this stroke width, make this kind of a yellow. Go to contents and we're going to add another group. And we're going to call this lines. So add a rectangle and add a fill. And we're going to make that fill white. Okay, so let's open up our rectangle path and we're going to adjust our size here. So let's uncheck our size dimensions and then make the first value 2 and the second value, just kind of crank it up a little bit. Let's highlight lines and you want to add a repeater. Open up the repeater. We're going to make 4 copies and we're going to set our rotation to 90 degrees. You want to make sure your anchor point and your position are both set X and Y values to 0. And the way we're going to move that is if you go to your rectangle path, you want to adjust your position. So if you pull this up, we can see they all 4 move up. And then you can kind of play with how this is going to look. I'm going to increase the size a little bit and then pull this position back down. Duplicate this lines group again, and we're going to make some more adjustments here. So let's open up our repeater and let's add, say, 20 copies. And then open up our transform properties for repeater. go to our rotation, and if you type in 360, that's how many degrees are in a circle, divided by the number of copies, which is 20, it'll give you a perfect circle. So see, I want them up a little bit higher, but I want them to be a lot shorter because I'm going to make a ring of lines around this. And let's add some more in here. So let's maybe make this 30 copies and then go back to our rotation. 360 divided by 30. We'll put them all in a perfect circle. And then we'll call this ring of lines. Change this color. We'll make this purple. Right now our size is 2 pixels wide, 50 long. Let's make this maybe 4 pixels wide to give a little bit more thickness. Go to our lines group at the very bottom. Duplicate that. And then if we open up our transform properties for the line group, not for the repeater, but for the line group, and we're going to rotate this by 45 degrees so it's kind of offset. And then we're going to make some more adjustments to this rectangle path. So we want this to be, again, we want this to be kind of short. So we'll say maybe 25 pixels long, but then we need to pull it out so it's out here. And actually, we want that a little bit longer, maybe 45 pixels long. And then I'm going to add in one more element. Put in a group, and we're going to call this light, and we're going to move this to the very top. And so this is going to be a light that's going to travel around our HUD element. And the way we get that is we're going to add an ellipse and a stroke. And it's important that you make this a stroke so that way we can control the thickness of it and how it moves with our trim paths. So let's just increase the size of our ellipse, and then we're going to also increase the size of our stroke. So I'm going to really just crank this up because it wants to extend out beyond our circle. With light highlighted, we're going to add a trim paths. And we're going to cut this to about the end percentage to about 20%. Okay, and now see, you get this kind of weird deforming here. So what we need to do is adjust either our ellipse path or our stroke size. So let's just kind of adjust some of these settings. If we adjust our ellipse path size, you get about like right there. And then actually let's decrease this even more, say 13%. And we want to change our color stroke. We're going to make this like a light blue. And then each one of these groups have their own transform properties. So you have a lot of control over each element. So what I want to do is adjust my opacity of my stroke. We're going to set this down to 10 and maybe go a little brighter, say 20. That looks good. So now we just need to set some expressions to make this thing move. I'm just going to kind of start from the top and go down. So we want our light, like I said, to kind of travel around. So let's go to the transform properties of light, and we're going to set an expression on our rotation of the entire group for light. So light, transform, rotation, option click on the rotation, and just type time times 25. Our next layer is going to be our inner ring. You can either adjust the rotation of the group or you can mess with this offset. You see on your trim paths, they basically will do the same thing for the effect we're trying to do. Option click onto offset and type wiggle 2, 200 and close that parentheses. Next layer is just a solid, so we don't need to mess with that because no kind of rotation will make a difference on that. Let's go to our dash, and then we're going to come down here to the transform properties of dash, option click rotation, and just type time times 35. See, this next layer here is going to be actually the border. So let's just type border 1, and then 2 down is going to be border 2 because I remember I put this white element in between those, and we'll call this white light. Option click onto offset and type wiggle. I'm going to say 1, 250. And so now let's keep moving down our blue segments. I want these to both move independently of one another. So we're actually going to set an expression on each one of these blue groups here. We don't want them to touch and we don't want them to be uniform. So with this highlighter, we're going to come down to trim paths. Option click onto offset and go wiggle 190 degrees. And then we can highlight that. Command C and come down to our blue layer down here. Go to our trim paths, option click offset and Command V. And now see, if you kind of get this where it looks like that they're kind of favoring this side, you can still adjust this. That's why I like to mess with the offset, because if we move our rotation around, and they're not going to stay completely opposite, but at least they won't be as close as they were before. Let's move this circle of purple lines. Since our orange stroke layer here is moving clockwise, we want to move that counterclockwise. So ring of lines, and let's go down to our rotation for this group. Go down to transform, option click on rotation, click time times, and we want this to go a little bit slower, so maybe negative 20. If you use negative as your value, then it's going to go counterclockwise. Positive values go clockwise. Lines 2 here is the outermost lines, and we want to set a wiggle expression on that as well. So come down to transform, rotation, option click on the rotation, and we'll go wiggle 0.5, 320. Actually, I want to add in more lines. So let's add in, let's make it 6. And then we need to adjust our rotation for our repeater. So we go 360 divided by 6 to even it out. And then maybe even make it a little bit shorter so it doesn't extend beyond. So it's going to take a little bit of adjusting here. It's kind of messing with these settings a little bit. So something about like that. Let me add in a few more even. So let's say 10. And so 360 divided by 10 is actually 36, but I'm going to go ahead and do the math. And so let's set this fill a little bit thinner. Let's make it 1. I'm going to set a rotation on that as well. So come down to our transform properties for the lines on rotation and option click on the rotation and go time times 15. So this is our HUD element so far, and maybe just make a few more adjustments. Let's make this inner ring, let's try 10, and then adjust the percentage of the end of the transform. So maybe 65, make it a little bit longer. Duplicate that ring layer, and we'll call this start. And I'm going to take off this trim paths. I want it to be a circle, a really small circle right in the middle. I'm going to set this at the same blue as our blue layer. Actually extend these lines here all the way down to the middle so they actually touch. So see, you can really get creative with this. I'm literally doing this on the fly, just kind of coming up with some ideas as I'm doing it. You can alter these and get different results fairly quickly. So highlight HUD element, go up to effect, stylize, we're going to add a glow. We're going to put this on top and we're going to make both colors white. Change our glow colors to A and B colors. Let's take our threshold down all the way and then just kind of play with our glow settings. I actually like this, I think, better without the glow. Okay, and now to save this as a preset, let's just highlight our contents, effects, and transform properties. Go up to animation, save animation preset. Make sure you're in Documents, Adobe. I'm using 2018 this episode, User Presets, and let's make a folder called HUD Elements. And then we'll just call this HUD01. Hit save and let that save. Then let's make sure that it's saved correctly. Let's just get rid of our contents here. Hit U to make sure we don't have any keyframes up, and we don't, and get rid of our effect. If we come over here to Effects and Presets, open up your animation presets. Under User Presets, we have HUD Elements, which is a folder we just created. Open that up, and we have HUD01. As you see, our glow element came over. I have it turned off, but you can turn it back on. And if we hit EE, you can see all of our time and wiggle expressions came over with it. So that is how you can make a HUD element and save it as a preset, and now you have it forever. HUD elements are very common in infographics and futuristic animations. Chances are you're going to come across them at some point or get a request from a client that wants HUD elements. There's no rule on how these should look, so let your imagination run wild when creating them. I hope this helped you out. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time. I'm going to go to bed.